Welcome, gang, wherever you're watching from in the world. This is the Pub Crawl channel in Australia. Well, it's been an awesome time recently. Caught the Iron Maiden show, the Future Past tour. Fucking unreal, man. The boys have still got it. It's fucking amazing. And did sample all the different beers from the Nomad Brewery. Well done, gang. Great selection of Iron Maiden beers. I don't know if you can still get them. I'm actually going to try and probably have another crack and see if I can get some more, but fantastic. How good is it when one of your favourite bands has their own beers? That's great. Okay, well, actually, and I also found this old Goldie. Probably bought this when I was about 13. Absolute legend to find that amongst me stuff. I come back from the concert and I was just pumped, and I've got to check some shit out. I even found like an old cooler there for my sister's 40th birthday. Flat out like a lizard king, Tasha Stanton. Righto, well, time's ticking. I have one remaining Hemingway's Brewery Wharf Street left. Now, I did buy, I got a carton online of these. Well, they sell them in halfies. But yeah, got them quick. And I'll tell you what, I was really impressed with this. I'm going on my way up there to check out the Hemingway's Brewery in Cairns. And you guys should too. Okay, here's cheers. Oh, I really can't get past how good these are. What do we got here? Proudly unfiltered and pasteurised. Probably, look, the only thing, it's a 6%er, but it is a sneaky 355. Gang, make them in bigger cans. Wharf Street IPA, Hemingway's freshest West Coast IPA, crafted in the iconic Shed 2 on Cairns Wharf. This brew pays homage to the daring spirit of 1912 and the epic voyage of IPAs from England to India. With a bold hoppy kick and a touch of bitterness, it's a taste of adventure in every sip. Experience a sip of history with a refined twist, straight from our historic home, refreshingly far north. Well, why wouldn't we see what it's like off the tap? In the Iron Maiden Stein, we'll just have a little snort out of there, just so you can see that. The lighting's not that great here this evening. Darky looking beer, but beautiful and creamy, and the smell sensational, man. Oh, lovely, lovely. Actually, fucking better out of the glass than the can, I think. The aroma, everything, there's not. Well, I can't see anything that makes this a shit beer, to be honest. Yeah, tiny subtle difference between the glass and the can, but I'll tell you what, I'm going this way. This is very, very nice. Have any of you guys tried this beer before? If you have, please leave your comments. It'd be great to have a conversation. Was Are You Okay Day the other day and things like that, and we all know that sometimes we struggle, so it's good to have a yarn with your mates. And that's the YouTube community out there. And don't forget to get around and check everybody's YouTube channels out. It's what it's about. There's a lot of great content, and you know, people that know beer's a lot better than I do. But anyway, I'm going to give this a fucking 9.5 out of 10. It's a bloody beauty. And I will get online and buy some more. I can't remember though, probably 60 bucks or something for whatever it was. But I'll drop the website down and you guys can check it out for yourselves. So, drink responsibly. Thanks for calling in the Pub Crawl channel. Up the irons. See ya.